to be quite happening for the Indian drone industry. Hi, my name is Sasha and let's find out the top 20 drone news from Indian drone industry. India suffered with its first ever terror drone attack where rogue drones were used to drop IEDs on Air Force Station Jammu. The attack has red flagged the need to acquire the latest anti-drone technologies as over 300 drones have been sighted along the LOC since August 5, 2019. PM Modi chaired a high-level meeting on security implications of drone in the aftermath of the Jammu attack. The UAS Rule 2021 will get some updation and the drafted rules will be released for 30 days public consultation from 10th July 2021. Now coming to some positive news, the much-awaited experimental BVLOS drone flight took off with the consortium of ANRA Technologies, Swiggy, Better Drones and IIT Roper. Taking the BVLOS trails forward, Throttle Aerospace has conducted the first medicine delivery drone flight in the outskirts of Bangalore. In a major step to support the drone industry, QCI has launched the NPNT testing tool for both developers and certification bodies. DGCA has given conditional exemption to HPCL for conducting aerial day and night surveillance of oil pipelines where omnipresent Robotech is likely to deploy their drones. In a remarkable step, NHAI has made drone-based video recording to be mandatory for all highway projects during the development, construction and OAM period. Aries Argo Limited gets the first permission granted for aerial spraying of agri-nutrients with IoTech World Aviation as partners. State Government of Haryana shows promising vision for drones as the CM has expressed his desire to form the Drone Corporation of Haryana and also procure 200 plus drones for conducting service. DGCA gave permission to West Central Railway Itarsi to use drones for surveillance and assessment of sites during derailment of or accidents. Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology Pune has received permission from DGCA for using drones to conduct atmospheric research in 5 different locations. Survey of India gets the another conditional exemption for large-scale mapping of inhabited areas of villages using drones under the Svamitva Scheme. Shimla Police is all set to acquire drones from Ideaforge to deploy them for aerial inspection, surveillance and for search and rescue missions. Opening up more opportunities for the agriculture industry, DGCA has given the permission to ICAR, National Rice Research Institute, Cuttack, for R&D of rice crops using drones. Now looking at some news from Indian Defence. Indian Navy is set to approach the Defence Ministry for the acquisition of 30 Predator armed drones from the US to counter the challenge posed by the Chinese Wing Loom 2 drone with precision strike capabilities. DRDO Center for Airborne Systems has started developing a lightweight onboard drone-mounted anti-radar jammer system for rotary wing swarm drones for Indian Army. Hindustan Aeronautical Limited and BEL own the bid for the production of India's most ambitious UAV Rustom-II. Mahanadi Coalfields Limited can now use drones for surveying their mining areas at Angul, Jharsuguda and Sundargarh after getting a note from DGCA. DGCA plans to revamp the Digital Sky platform by the end of this year. This will enable automated registrations and flight approvals among other procedures for drones. Following the footsteps of Telangana government, Odisha government mulls use of drones to deliver COVID vaccines to remote areas and approach DGCA for required approvals. Sashastra Seema Bal and the Excise Department to use drones to find illicit liquor dens in the forest areas near the Indo-Nepal border. That's all for this month's Drone News Express. To get more updates, follow our Drone Helpline Facebook and LinkedIn page. Link is provided in our description box below. You can also provide us with your views, ideas and feedback. Thanks for watching. Do like our video. Do not forget to share and subscribe to our Drone Helpline YouTube channel.